I'm Tyler Trumbauer, and on this edition of Sports Bite, I will be previewing the upcoming varsity football season. To do that, to my left, I have the head varsity football coach here at Northern Lehigh, Mr. Tout. Mr. Tout, how are you, sir?
Good, thanks for having me.
No problem, thanks for coming in. I truly, truly appreciate it. So I want to talk about the upcoming season, but before we get to that, let's jump back to 2012. 7-3 record, you got to the districts. You played caddy, took the loss there, but you still got some postseason play in it.
Right.
Now you got some months to reflect on it. What was 2012 like in your mind?
Enjoyable, you know, enjoyable season. I thought we got a lot out of our team last year. We were in every game. We had some nice victories last year. I think the highlight may have been the Bangor game at home. You know, they had come in with one loss, and we really, you know, played outstanding that night. But, you know, I thought our kids did a good job of just getting better as the year went on.
Gotcha. So you had some superb athletes on last year's team. I mean, the top three people in your offense was Darian, Dan Marsh, and Caleb Johnson.
Right.
So, I mean, now you lost all three of them to graduation. Right. Caleb obviously going to play at Harvard, which is a great step coming from this program. What's going to be like losing them and having to replace them on the gridiron and also in the locker room, which they were a key part to as well?
Right. Well, you know, reality is we lost about 85% of our offense with those three players. So, you know, it's inevitable, and you just we hadn't focused on that. We just focused on the pieces that we have this year to the puzzle. And, you know, we'll try to put our guys in the right places to win games this year.
They were pieces of the puzzle, and you're going to get new pieces of the puzzle. Any additions that really have shown so far this season?
Yeah, we've been really pleasantly surprised with a lot of our younger players. We've made some moves with some older guys. Theo Young at fullback, he had played tight end coming through. He's done a nice job. He seems a natural fit. Steven Ingles has really done a nice job. And, you know, we think the strength of our team is our guys up front. You know, I'm sure everyone sees in the hallways we're a little heftier up front with Jake Moser, Cameron Cates. So, you know, we like that we have a little bit of size this year.
Do you feel that's going to be an advantage? You like that? I mean, the Colonial League is, of the Lehigh Valley, one of the tougher leagues. You're always, every team's running the ball. So is that definitely going to be an advantage for you guys, you think, in the trenches as the season goes along?
You hope so. You know, it's. I think, again, that's our strength this year is what we have up front. In years past, it may have been more of our skill players. But, you know, you just, I hopefully that's what we're banking on is as the year goes on, we're going to have bigger guys. They're going to wear down other teams.
You had one big guy, especially tall-wise, and that was Nick Baresh, senior Nick Baresh. Unfortunately, in the scrimmage, ACL and I believe an MCL tear, or am I correct?
Both exact ACL was the, but he had a sprain as well. Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So he's ACL gone for the year. What kind of losses does that mean to this program and to Nick as a football player individual?
Right. I think our coaching staff, we feel horrible for Nick, you know, first and foremost, you know, as far as what it does to our team, you know, that's a big loss for us. But he had really worked so hard. And I don't know if everybody in the school saw that. You know, all the work that he had put in last December to improve himself, and he had been getting some looks by Lehigh and, you know, was hoping to play maybe at a Patriot-level school. And right now, with him losing the senior year, you know, I think it's something that he's, you know, that we were looking forward to seeing him maybe be our next athlete that went on to play college football. But, you know, he's really, as soon as he had the surgery, he came back and he's been a leader. You know, that's which I expect from him. But that's what I'm proud of. He's a guy, he had surgery, could have stayed at home. He was in our locker room Friday night. So even though he can't play, he's still absolutely a big part of our team.
That's a great thing to see. So he's a senior leader, even though he's a little bit hobbled right now. So other seniors we got, who really has been stepping up as a senior and really filling that role as I am now a senior and taking it on with pride, embracing it?
Well, we have a couple guys. Theo Young's done a nice job. Steven Ingles, Jake Moser. Jason Loff has really been a leader for us in the first couple weeks. Chance DeLong, Chance has looked really crisp at quarterback and done a nice job there.
You brought up Chance DeLong. Let's talk about him a little bit. How exactly have you liked him in the quarterback role? I mean, he's had some years, but, you know, he sat behind good quarterbacks. Dylan Hoffman, you go back, then you go to Dan Marsh. And so he's been able to see guys play and play at high levels. How is he doing now through scrimmages and some game play?
He's been solid. We're really happy with his development. He's played. You know, even though Danny was our starting quarterback last year, Chance played the position. We played him at the varsity level last year, so he's doing what we expect of him. He's been very solid there.
Now let's take a look at the Colonial League as a whole. A lot of tough teams. I mean, Caddy was fierce last year, expected to be the same. Banger, Penn Argyle, I mean, they're all always there in recent years. And so have you guys been as well. What's your forecast? How are you seeing the Colonial League through your eyes this year?
Well, you know, there's no bones about it. This, to me, is an up year for our league. And when I say that, I mean, it seems like everybody is a senior-dominated team or senior-oriented. So, and we're playing some older guys and some younger guys, but we still have the same expectations. We just, you know, our goal is to go out, get better every week, and be competitive and win on a Friday night. So, you know, that's where we're at. That hasn't changed here in over a decade, and it's not going to.
So let's go out on this question. What is your goal for 2013? You as the head coach, your coaching staff, what are you guys trying to do with the 2013 season?
Well, it's let's get better every week. You know, I always keep it simple. You know, and if you keep it that simple, you know, are we a better team this week than we were last week? And a week from now, if we're a better team next week than we were this week, if we could do that for 10 weeks, I think you'll be successful. You don't necessarily worry about wins and losses, but if you're able to get better every week, then it should carry into your games as well. So that's all we look for, is let's get better every week.
Absolutely, that's great. Thanks, Coach, I appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
And that's Head Coach Tout. He's been with a lot of successes, both each week and in the win and loss column. I'm Tyler Trumbauer. This has been Sports Bite. So long, folks.